Today we're talking about the benefits of CBD. So let me give you a common scenario. You go see your doctor, you have some kind of a symptom showing up. The doctor gives you a pharmaceutical for the symptom. You take the pharmaceutical and there's side effects to the pharmaceutical that you're taking. It's very common that you're gonna go back to the doctor, they're gonna give you another pharmaceutical for that side effect. And you know, we have statistics that show that over the age of 50, it's very common that people are on at least 5 different pharmaceuticals. In this conversation, it's really critical to understand the endocannabinoid system. The endocannabinoid system is a system that oversees and regulates all the other systems of your body. When there is a deficiency in the endocannabinoid system, it leaves us to not functioning at our best. So to make sure that we're functioning from optimal levels and that all our systems are in balance, it's important to kind of understand that CBD is a phytocannabinoid that supports the endocannabinoid system. The endocannabinoid system has receptors throughout your body. There's CB1 receptors and there's CB2 receptors. CB1 is primarily in your brain and your spinal cord. CB2 is primarily in your immune system and peripheral nervous system. So in other words, they influence every system of your body. So if you have arthritis, that's basically inflammation in your joints. If you have irritable bowel disease, that's basically inflammation in your gut. But because you have CB1 or CB2 receptors throughout your body, CBD can support the endocannabinoid system and help the body go back into a greater state of balance so that inflammation in the joints can clear up, as well as the inflammation in the gut can also clear up. So this is how CBD can work and help so many people with so many different things. When the researchers were trying to find why the THC was creating the psychoactive effect in the brain, they found this system of the body. So the endocannabinoid system is very, very important to get a handle on. So here's the magic and the beauty of CBD. CBD is a non-psychoactive phytocannabinoid that supports the natural cannabinoid system of the body. When it does that, it helps everything go back into a greater state of balance. And when we do that, the symptoms start to fade away. The anxiety, the depression, you start to sleep better, all kinds of pain issues start to fade away because your body's in that greater state of balance. I work with a lot of brain trauma and in brain health in general. And what I've recognized is that the CBD, the neuroprotection is gonna be something that really changes the way that we look at these degenerative diseases. Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, dementia, all of these start in the hippocampus. It's a part of our brain where a lot of our memory is stored. And in the research, it shows that that part of the brain starts to shrink first in relationship to something like Alzheimer's. Well, in clinical studies, CBD has shown to stimulate neurogenesis, meaning new brain cells start to actually be generated in the hippocampus. Not only that, it helps maintain its healthy, normal state. The third thing I want to talk about and that you should kind of keep in mind is just the antioxidant properties of CBD. The government actually patented both the antioxidant properties and the neuroprotectant properties. So I want you to be aware of that. So they, when they were doing their research, deemed that significant enough to actually take out a patent on it. It's been talked about as one of the biggest breakthroughs in relationship to human physiology in the last decade. So it's something we really want to pay attention to and start to get really clear on the research. So if you can keep that in mind, those three very big, powerful benefits of CBD, the neuroprotection, the anti-inflammation, and the antioxidant properties. Then you start to get a sense of why CBD can be so powerful and help so many people with so many different types of imbalances and different symptoms.